Hey friend, Graham here from recordingrevolution.com. And today I want to talk about the decision of whether you should specialize as a musician or as an artist or someone in the music industry, whether you should specialize in one skill or if you should be a jack of all trades, as they say. In other words, should you focus on picking your one thing and just going all in on songwriting or being a singer or all in on being a recording engineer or a mastering engineer? And bring on other people to help you out in those other areas or collaborate with lots of different kinds of people? Or should you really learn all of the trades and do them all? Because I hear the debate back and forth going on, and the industry is continuing to evolve and morph. And I think things have changed enough over the decades that this is a legitimate debate. For example, years ago, it was more commonplace for people to specialize. So you would have the Frank Sinatras and the Whitney Houstons of the world, these amazing performers and singers, that's what they would do. They would sing and perform. They didn't write their own songs. They didn't record their own music. They didn't mix their own music. They certainly didn't publish it and distribute it. They were specialized at one thing, and they had a whole team of other people to write them great songs, produce their recordings to sound amazing, etc. Now, bands have typically been more likely to write their own material, write and arrange their own stuff and perform it, although there are bands that have songs written for them. So that has been going on a bit more. But as the decades have moved forward, this has become more and more commonplace where artists and bands do almost all of it themselves, write their own songs, record, produce, perform, sometimes even shoot their own music videos. There is the ability now to do a lot of this. And there's three reasons why this is taking place. One is accessibility to technology and knowledge and education. It's just so easy to get the equipment you need to record and produce your own music, as I talk about a lot. But it's also so easy to hop on YouTube and learn how to use the equipment, how to produce, how to record, how to mix so it actually sounds professional, but also how to write better songs, how to break into the industry as an artist, how to grow your fan base, how to distribute your music more, how to arrange better songs, how to manage yourself as an artist, how to film your own music videos. I mean, there is so much information out there. So access to technology and knowledge is one. Two, another reason why artists and bands are becoming more of a jack of all trades is because labels and people who sort of are key holders or gatekeepers to certain opportunities expect new artists to have almost fully developed recordings, which is way different than it was even 20 years ago. When I was growing up, when I was in high school and college, there was still the world of you had a demo or you were found live at a venue and someone would see raw talent and they'd be willing to invest in you and then put you in the studio and make a record and shop it out and promote it, etc. These days, because fewer people are buying records and there's less money to go around, labels will not take that kind of risk. They're very strategic and very conservative, so they want a sure bet. And the only way to have a sure bet is to hear a finished record that already sounds like it could be on the radio. So they A, know that you can sound like that, and B, so they don't have to record it themselves. So a lot of artists these days are making their own records so that they can be presentable to big labels and distribution companies and things like that, publishing companies. And so that's one reason why a lot of artists are becoming a jack of all trades, is so that they can already be done, as it were. And the third reason a lot of artists do this is because they want control, creative control. They want to have a bigger say on how their music actually sounds in the end, how it comes together. Because in the past, you would maybe write the song, maybe arrange it and perform it live. But when you got signed or you starting to get somewhere, you get in the studio, you have a producer who would kind of take the reins creatively and artistically. You'd have engineers making decisions on what tones and what microphones and placement, and then mix engineers who would balance the mix a different way than you were used to hearing in the studio, mastering engineers who would tweak it even further. So by the time you heard it on the radio or heard it on the final record, it could sound completely different than where it started, and that could be a bad thing. It could be a good thing, could be a bad thing, where it's not what you envision in your head. I think of a good example for me as a band that I follow is the band Thrice, and they made tons of records in big studios, major label deals, and years back, they wanted to make a record that they ended up calling the Alchemy Index, and it was really four EPs that they released in two sets. And for this project, I remember reading interviews where the band said, you know what, we want to record it ourselves. And they built out and bought a Pro Tools rig. Tepe, their lead guitar player, had learned a little bit about Pro Tools and was figuring it out. And they built out a little home studio and they took their time because they didn't know how to record or produce very well. But they took their time, made the record themselves just because they wanted it to sound the way they wanted it to sound. They wanted to mix it the way they wanted. If they wanted the vocals on the left with weird distortion on it, that's what they wanted. If they wanted to balance a certain way, they wanted to balance a certain way, and they wanted complete artistic control. So they took it upon themselves to learn the recording and mixing part of things, and they recorded and mixed that entire project themselves, and it was mastered by somebody else, but then released on their label. So the question is, should you specialize and become amazing at one thing? Or should you follow this trend of becoming a jack of all trades? Well, I think the answer lies somewhere in the middle. I think it's best personally to have one core strength that identifies you, but then also be aware of all the other skills and learn them enough to be able to do them yourself if you need to. And here's why. Let's say your core strength is singer-songwriter. You write songs and you're a great singer, okay? That's your core thing. It would behoove you to learn how to record and mix and master your own music, even if you're going to hire or collaborate with someone to record and mix your record, because that way you understand the process. So when he or she is recording or mixing or mastering your record, you can speak the language, you can make suggestions, you understand the tools, you understand the techniques, so that you actually can communicate better and better direct and help your collaborator achieve a better result. Even if that person's a better mix engineer than you, knowing how to mix gives you a huge leg up as a singer-songwriter than being completely in the dark and saying, look, all I know how to do is write and sing, so you handle the production. Now also, let's say you're a mix engineer, okay? You love to mix. And so you take tracks from clients and you mix and churn out great mixes, and that's what you do. That's your core strength. That's your specialization. It would be very helpful and wise to be able to also record and master. Why? Well, if someone wants to hire you to mix, they might like you so much they want to know if you also can record their next project so that you can be a part of the creative vision from day one. And if you can, you can say, sure, I can definitely record for you. Otherwise, you have to hire it out. Or this happened a lot for me is as I'm receiving tracks to mix, a lot of my clients will say, do you also master or do I need to hire a mastering engineer? And I ultimately leave it up to them, but I know how to master music. I've mastered plenty of records. And so I say, yeah, I can totally master your record. And in fact, I'll add it to you at a discounted cost because I'm already mixing your record, let's say. But I give them the option. Here are a couple other mastering engineers that I think are fantastic. Or if you want to keep it in-house, I'm happy to master. And a lot of times I get more work, more business. It's almost like an upsell because I have that skill. I'm able to give that service if they want it. And the benefit for them is that it's one less person for them to have to hire and deal with. And it gives them one consistent point of contact to sort of see their project through to completion. And that can be a huge win for the artist. So maybe the natural question for you is, if you happen to specialize in one thing, how do you broaden your set of skills? How do you quickly acquire the knowledge to become more well-rounded as fast as possible? Well, first, take a bunch of courses on the subject you're trying to learn. If you want to learn mastering, take courses on mastering. Watch tutorials on mastering. If you want to learn how to write songs, if you're a band but you don't know how to write songs, take songwriting courses, okay? There are a ton of trainings and tutorials out there for free on the Recording Revolution channel. I've got hundreds of videos, all free, on how to write and record and mix and master. All that kind of stuff is there for you. I also have paid courses that I go super in-depth. There is a lot of material just here on my channel. But there's a lot of other channels as well. This is a great time to be looking for knowledge because you will find it and you have access to that. So I would say watch a bunch of tutorials. Always be a student. But you know what's even faster than watching tutorials and acquiring knowledge that way? Is knowing someone who is very good at the thing you're trying to get good at and talking to them directly and asking them questions. So for example, if you're trying to get better at vocal recording, if you know someone who records vocals really, really well, or they're a singer and they record their own vocals, yes, you could watch a bunch of tutorials and yes, that will help you. But if you knew someone who you think their vocal recordings sound amazing and they do it themselves, you could literally ask them, hey, here's what I'm doing in my studio. Here are what my vocals sound like. Something's off. What do you hear? What's wrong with it? How can I make this better? And then they could listen to it and say, okay, well, where are you placing the microphone? How close are you to the microphone? Oh, you're about 2 to 3 inches away. Maybe try backing up 5 to 8 inches and see if that solves the problem. This is happening in seconds. I mean, this is a very, very fast way to address the problem, talk to someone who has a lot of expertise in that area, and then they can give you immediate feedback, ask you specialized questions so you can get to the root of the problem faster. Because if you watch a bunch of tutorials, we as educators can only guess what are the common roadblocks and try to address those roadblocks, but I don't know you when you're watching my video exactly what your problem is or what your circumstances are, so I can't give you tailored advice in a tutorial, no matter if it's paid or free. So having someone you can just talk to and say, here's where I'm stuck, what do you think? If they're an expert in that area, you can get instant knowledge that's tailored to what you need, which allows you to grow faster. Or if you're trying to get better at mixing and your low end is messed up and it's all muddy, yes, you can watch a bunch of tutorials, but if you know a great mix engineer, you can say, hey, can you listen to my mix? What am I doing wrong? How do I get the low end to sit right and get rid of the mud? They can tell you, they can hear it, they can give you specialized advice immediately to your situation. I can't stress enough how important it is to surround yourself with people who are better than you in the areas you want to grow in, to connect with like-minded musicians who are excellent at their craft and are willing to share and willing to help. You will grow faster. You will expand your knowledge set and your skill set faster than any other way possible. And that will give you more value in the marketplace. That will give you more control over your own productions and recordings. That will help you grow as an artist and do better in this space. The little tips and tricks and the years of knowledge that are stored up in their brain just come out and are so invaluable, and you just can't get that anywhere else. So now that you know that the fastest way to get ahead and become more well-rounded in the music space is to work with and surround yourself with people that are super crazy talented and better than you in that area, and they have more experience than you, then what do you do with that? What if you don't know those people, all right? What if you're all alone? What if you live in a city where you don't have those kind of people, or you don't know where to even begin connecting with those people if you are in the city? Well, I've got really good news for you. I've been trying to solve this problem, and I have recently launched a brand new community site called Recording Revolution VIP, and I think this is gonna solve this problem for you. Recording Revolution VIP is an online community of musicians, artists, songwriters, bands, recording and mix engineers, mastering engineers, performers, music industry experts, people who are in film and cinema and who do TV and licensing and who make songs for video games and everywhere in between. These are people that you can connect with right now. You can get feedback on your music or your career from. You can collaborate with. You can just bounce ideas off of. They are like-minded. They are passionate about music, and they want to connect with other people like you. That's why they're there. This is an amazing community that I've put together that you have to be a part of. I know from experience that you'll create more music, better sounding music, more consistently when you have a network of people around you holding you accountable, who know you're trying to make music, who are expecting you to put it out there. That subtle pressure, it gets built into your workflow. You'll not only pump out great music, but you'll do a better job at it. And that's what Recording Revolution VIP is centered on, is this network. It's an instant network of incredible musicians for you to plug into. Also inside of VIP, I have brought together some of my friends in the music industry who are the best at what they do, and asked them to create amazing courses to include inside of this community, absolutely free for you, on topics such as songwriting, taught by an amazing songwriter who has written songs for Celine Dion and the Backstreet Boys. A course on music production and arrangement by a Grammy-nominated producer who's worked with Sia and Justin Timberlake and Jason Derulo and a ton of others. A course on creating a career in music taught by Taylor Swift's former manager. And more courses added to the community over time. It's an incredible resource. And that's not all that's included with VIP. I've created Recording Revolution VIP to be the go-to resource and community for musicians all over the world. So as part of being a VIP member, here's also what you get. You get access to the best forum and community of like-minded musicians. Imagine everybody that follows the Recording Revolution together in one dedicated private space, helping each other out. Musicians, songwriters, mixers, other instrumentalists, if you need someone in your band to play bass, if you need someone to play cello, if you need someone to master your record, if you need someone to just to collaborate with and write lyrics to your song, it's all there because all the people are there. Also, every month there is a live Q&A call with me where you can jump on, hang out with me for an hour, ask me any question you like on music, production, the industry, whatever, and I'm here to answer your questions live. Also, I'll be bringing on my friends from time to time, experts in the music industry, and bringing them on to answer your questions about whether it's breaking into the industry as an artist or mastering or songwriting or production or making music for video games or whatever it is. These people are gonna be on the calls from time to time as well to give you a leg up in your journey. Also, there will be monthly recording and production challenges with prizes. So every month you'll be held accountable to make music. So at the very least, in a whole year, you'll have created 12 new songs because you'll be following along with these challenges. But also there are prizes every month for just jumping in and taking the challenge. The winner's drawn at random. You don't have to be good. It doesn't matter. You have the same opportunity to win just by completing the challenge and getting your music made. And this is just the tip of the iceberg of what you get as a musician inside the VIP community. And I've got some even better news for you. For the next 2 weeks, I'm gonna allow anybody who joins VIP to get a free month to start. That's right, you can jump in right now, start connecting with musicians all over the world in the forum, take the challenges, potentially win prizes, jump on a live Q&A, watch the free mini courses, all of that for free for 30 days just to test it out to see if VIP is the community for you. And if after the free month you choose to stay on as a paying member of VIP, I've made it incredibly affordable so that it's within reach of every single musician, no matter what budget you're on. It's cheaper than Spotify, it's cheaper than Netflix. And inside, you get a comprehensive music education across all kinds of topics and a world-class network of amazing musicians. But if you just take the free month and that's all you want and you want to leave after that, it's totally cool as well. Also, 10% of all sales of VIP memberships go to music-related charities, specific ones that actually put instruments and music technology and education in the hands of children and students who don't have access to it. No matter how affordable gear gets or how accessible training is, there's still people that can't access this stuff, don't have the ability to afford it. So there are amazing organizations that put this stuff directly in their hands for free. I'm a huge advocate of that. I'm an advocate of giving and I'm an advocate of music education. And so part of your membership is gonna go to fund those charities so that other kids have access to the same stuff you and I do. So if you'd like to upgrade your skills to connect with an amazing network of world-class musicians and producers and engineers, and if you wanna get encouragement, accountability, and feedback, and world-class education, then claim your free month of Recording Revolution VIP while this offer is still out there. Just go to recordingrevolution.com/VIP. All the details are there. Get your free 30 days, and you can decide if you wanna stay on as a member after that. I can't wait to see you inside of the community. I look forward to hanging out with you there. And that's all for me today. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing to these videos, and I'll see you on another video real soon.